Rob Ryan was opening for me in Bristol.
Here's a story I thought was going to get laughs but got hugs. Instead, I was trying to describe my 14th birthday. I had gotten home from school. My mother, she had been drinking. And I go, all right, I go to pop something in the fridge. And I noticed that she also got me a birthday cake. It was from the supermarket. I see the little cardboard box and the ribbon. And I was like, that's awesome. I'm going to enjoy some of that later. I go hang out with some friends. I come home around 7 o'clock. Now, she's just gone, like passed out, done. I go to the kitchen. The cake is also gone. Ooh, yeah, now I'm starting to get nervous. So I start retracing my steps. I'm thinking, if that was a cake, where would I be? And then I look and I see the box, right? But now it's empty, flattened, and wedged between her and the couch. So over the last couple of hours, she had eaten the entire thing. And now, I try not to take this personally, which is difficult. Literally, my name was written on it. You kind of felt like she knew what she was doing there, you know? Kind of hard to avoid. And I had a guy at a show yell out one time, was it an ice cream cake? And I was like, I think you're missing the point, sir. I'm not sure paying close attention. But then he doubled down. He's like, no, because an ice cream cake is easier to eat than a regular cake. Which is definitely true. It's just not the reason people don't do that, sir. I don't... Did someone say something here? Oh, it needs to be eaten quicker? Yeah, that's true. There's a bit of a time limit on that, too. Mm-hmm. I think people can go through a gallon of ice cream easier than a cake. I definitely conceded that point to him. But in my mind, I'm just like, yeah, that's not the mental calculus, usually. It's not, can I get through it? It's, should I do this, or should I not? Forget for a moment that it was technically my cake, right? No, that's 100% true. You just provided another decent reason why you gotta get through that shit. You can't start an ice cream cake and not finish it. I guess that's kind of a good, right? You don't want that freezer burn, you don't want that weird refrozen thing. There's a bunch of good reasons. Once again, not the reason. I'm sure as an audience we could come up with a plethora of reasons why an ice cream cake would be easier to consume than a regular cake, but one more time, not the reason people don't do that. Typically, right? So, even if it was her birthday, that's still insane. Wait, one more time. Yeah. And my name was on it. That's another good reason why not. I like that, yeah. You know what? I'm going to go out on a limb here and say, even if the name wasn't on it, let's say you're at work, okay? You pop open the freezer. Hey, Mike, look, a birthday cake. But no one's fucking name is on it. My birthday now. Still, I think it's not the reason. Give me one more reason. I want to hear your third reason why. Maybe... you think you get away with one? You know what's interesting? Because this thought has actually plagued me to this day too. Right? When did she decide to eat it all? Did she cut out a slice and things kind of got out of hand? Or did she take a fork straight through the center like, yeah, fuck it, let's do this. Like, who cares? Who cares? Because once you see a slice, you know you fucked up. You know somebody cut into the office cake, right? Just get rid of the evidence. Why not? What I'm trying to say is, even if it was her birthday, I think that's still insane behavior. Like, you know, some people say that if you drink socially, that's okay, but if you do too much alone, maybe you have a problem. Well, I say that goes doubly for cake. That's what I say. Socially, not a problem. Polish one off on your own, talk to somebody. That's all I'm saying. And what do I add about you? There is something in your past that you're trying to justify. That's what I say. I do now. You haven't eaten cake since you were 5? Because you know, oh, very interesting. Oh, okay. I'm not even a huge fan either. Like, I'll take a brownie or some shit over that. No, nothing for you? Okay, no problem. That's cool. Yeah, ice cream sounds delicious. Is this your, are you guys together here, Steve?
Something. All right.
You're good friends, okay. He's like, I'm not going to cross that line. I don't think I'm going to. Glad to have you out. You're wonderful. So I'm older still. We're just gonna move on from the ice cream. And
during the Q&A, someone said that they had 2 questions. So, before the second one.
If this second one is about ice cream cake, I'm gonna lose my fucking mind. there's a local phrase, girtlash. What do you think it means?
A local phrase, what is it?
Girtlash.
Girtlash.
Girtlash?
Girtlash.
Girtlash. Oh, girtlash. I thought girtlash was when a girt hits you from behind. Girtlash?
Girtlash. Okay, I think girtlash is when you're so pissed drunk on the street and you just got anything that's gotta come out comes out.
I think it was just a well-known town drunk named Gertrude. And then from then on, we were like, look at that girtlash. So this is local to Bristol?
So I saw
someone want to give us a
closer to right.
You want to, someone in the front here.
That
is fucking girtlash.
That's fucking girtlash. Oh, well, that puts it in context. Now we just know it's an adjective or a noun.
And for her, maybe it's melted ice cream?
London, Rob had done the same joke, this time uninterrupted, and during the Q&A.
Hey, what is happening right now? This is a Q&A. Just to say, do you have a question?
No, not a question, but I wanted to give you something for Rosh Hashanah.
I appreciate that, but can you do that after the show? Because this is getting weird. Okay, thank you very much. That's okay. Thank you, I appreciate that, but I don't even like opening a gift in front of the person who gave it to me, let alone a fucking audience. So that would be very weird. There'd be a lot of pressure. Like, if it's good, that's awesome. But if it's weird, I have to be like, oh, thank you. And then I'm sure it's going to be wonderful. I'm sure. Thank you very much.
Did you have a gift for me? Because I did get a gift. That's a Steve thing. Just about to give me present.
Do you have an empty cake box by any chance? Yes.
Question is, how do you get to choose or select your supporting
acts? How do I choose my supporting acts? Tell your brother I'm not hiring him. Someone says, dude, you want me to fire Rob? Fuck off.
Watching and sharing this video. If you don't already, make sure to follow and subscribe. I'm on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, Twitter, and many more, including Patreon. If you join at patreon.com/Steve Hofstetter, you'll see videos like this before anybody else. And once a week, I will post a video exclusively for my patrons. Most importantly, come see me live. I do shows all over the world. If you want to know if I'm going to be performing close to you, go to stevehofstetter.com and find out tour dates and get tickets. See you soon.